Hi, this is Sylvester from EasyInspect. I will in this video show you some of the new cool stuff we have developed in Inspection Cloud. I know it's been a while, but it's simply because we have been busy making all of these new cool stuff. Okay, so let's jump right into it. First thing, when you go into the edit tool, you will see on the right we have replaced the point cloud or the viewer for it. It's now much more responsive. It's using what's called adaptive point sizing, meaning that when you get close to the points, it will no longer kind of disappear as it did before. So it still appears dense. But you can, of course, change that in the settings. It's on your left side as usual. You can change the point sizing to fixed, and you can see the points are getting much smaller. In adaptive, which is standard, you can also change the size of the points. So we can make them smaller or we can make them really big. We can also change the point cloud to display an elevation model. So this way it becomes increasingly easier to understand height differences in your model. Okay, so what you also may have noticed is that all of the issues is now being displayed in the point cloud. So we have these annotations or labels. We can jump right into it. So here it will in Danish say we have a hole. And right now it's kind of covering the damage or the issue in this case. So we may want to move this label for visualization purposes. So we can click this button and we simply just move it a bit so it becomes more visual. We can click the eye to open it up and watch all of the images displaying that exact damage. And we can click open annotation to open up that image. Let's just close the sidebars so we have a bit more space to work with. And sorry about the sizing, it's a bit downsized for the video. Working on the full screen, it will appear you have much more space to work with. So, but what you may have noticed is that when we switch the image, let's do it here. You can see the 3D scene is moving alongside. So we have now made this completed 2D and 3D synchronization from the high resolution image to the 3D. What we can do with the issue is that we can filter it, or we can filter all of the images. So clicking that filter button, it will find all of the images displaying that exact area. So now when we browse through the images, we can see all of the images will be displaying that exact area. All right. So, and when we open up our right side pane here, we can see all of the issues we have. And when we want to look at these issues, we can simply hover the camera and we can see it will fly to the location of those issues. As soon as I leave the camera again, it will fly back to the position I was in before. And if I click the camera, it will stay in that position so we can start to work with the issue of interest. You can also dictate how you want the camera view to be like. So when you fly to, for instance, this issue, if we want to look at it just like this, we can simply go and update camera. So whenever we move away from this and click or hover it, we can see we fly back to that exact location or camera position as before. What we also did is we created measurements in the system. We had that before, but they were not persisted in the old version. And of course, you need to persist your measurements. So let's just try and make one. I'll simply measure this. And we can see it's now being saved on our right side here. when you click the distance or the measurement, you will get all the details of the measurement. And again, as I showed, we can switch the unit system to imperial if we want to have it in feet instead of meters. Just like I showed with the issues, we can also filter all of the images by the measurement in this case. So clicking this, we can now see all of the images where all the points of the measurement are visible. Also, we see that the measurements are being synchronized between 2D and 3D. So if I move one of the points, we can see it's being reflected in the 2D image right away. So, but the big reveal and the coolest feature I haven't shown yet, or maybe you have noticed, is our real-time location and synchronization. So when I work with the point cloud and hover the mouse, you can see the cursor from point cloud, meaning that whenever we find something and just hover it, we can see that exact position in the 2D image. Okay, but we have also developed the opposite. So just moving the mouse to the 2D image, we can now see that we have the cursor from 2D in real time showing the position in our 3D scene. So if we zoom in a bit, having an image like this, it can be really cumbersome or actually more or less impossible to know what we're working at. If this was a tall bridge with concrete, it would look just the same as all of the other images, and we would have no idea what the location and the size of this was. So if we zoom out a bit, let me just hide all of the measurements and issues. Okay, so we can now see when I move around in the 2D image like so, we can see exactly in the 3D scene where we're working. And if we want to make a measurement, let's just zoom in to that location. So if we want to make a measurement, we can actually do it in the 2D scene now. I just click and click, and we can now see the measurement again. And I can edit it from the 3D, as I showed before. So completely synchronized 2D and 3D. Awesome stuff. Haven't seen it anywhere else. But we think it's extremely useful for these kind of inspection tasks. Let me know in the comments what you think. Contact us if you want a trial of the platform. And looking forward to getting your feedback on the new features.